Welcome to MooMooMath and Science. In this video, I'd like to talk about how to read a chemical equation. Chemical reactions occur all around us. They can be exciting like these fireworks, and also helpful like these fires. A chemical reaction can be represented by using a chemical equation. Let's break down this chemical equation and see what information it contains. First, the reactants are found on the left of the arrow, and the products are on the right of the arrow. This equation has CH4, which is methane, combining with oxygen, represented by O2. The plus marks on the left of the arrow tells you which elements or compounds are combining. The arrow tells you what it will produce or yield. The right side of the arrow are your products, or what is produced. The products in this equation are CO2, which is carbon dioxide, and H2O, which is water. Each capital letter represents a new element, and each element has a symbol. The symbol for every element can be found on the periodic table. A number behind a letter is called a subscript and represents how many ions of the element are in the chemical equation. H2O tells you that the compound has 2 hydrogen ions and 1 oxygen. What do the numbers in front of a letter tell you? These are called coefficients and are the numbers that represent the number of moles of each substance involved in the reaction. In this example, 2H2 plus O2 yield 2H2O. 2 moles of hydrogen react with 1 mole of oxygen and produce 2 moles of water. Atoms are neither created nor destroyed. All of the atoms on the reactant side, the left side, must equal the products on the right side. In other words, it must be balanced. If you count the atoms with this reaction, you will notice that it is not balanced. This new equation is balanced because you have equal number of elements on both sides. I will leave a note in the show notes for a video that I created on balancing equations. You can also indicate the physical states of the reactants and products. Here are some symbols. S equals solid, L equals liquid, G equals gas, AQ equals dissolved in water. In this chemical equation, you have a solid plus a liquid, and it produces a hydrogen gas dissolved in water. So there we go. Chemical reactions represented by a chemical equations. Reactants on the left of the arrow, products on the right. Thanks for watching, and MooMooMath uploads a new math and science video every day. Please subscribe and share.